Here are this week's top stories. The Colour Run 2015 continues to spread happy and healthy vibes. UAE holds National Lifeguard Championships 2015. Dubai Health Authority celebrates UAE Innovation Week. And on Celebrity Fit, Miss Universe Olivia Culpo shares her fitness and beauty secrets. I'm Rachel. Welcome to What's Up. The Colour Run 2015 continues to spread happy and healthy vibes. In its most recent edition, thousands of colour runners turned up to join the happiest 5K on the planet. Here's Afra, who spoke to some of the runners.
In Dubai with the happiest 5K in the planet. I'm Afra Aljoun and welcome to the Colour Run. Love and change, survivors of the pain, we never fade away. All participants must run the 5 kilometer distance, and in every kilometer they will be covered in colours. If you're not a seasoned runner, you don't need to worry about it because the timing is untimed race. And also, it's all about having fun. It's not about the competition. We are indestructible. Indestructible. With me here, Stephanie and Craig, the participants in the Colour Run. Hi guys, how are you?
Hi, good.
Great. Thanks.
So how was your run? Tell me.
Very happy.
Why is it the happiest colour run in the planet?
Good vibes, good people, good colour.
Why is it the happiest colour run in the planet?
Because it's full of colours and happy people and joy, and you get to exercise and be active in a good way.
Hi.
Hi.
Why did you come here today?
To enjoy the have fun. Running the colour.
And is it the happiest colour run in the planet?
Yes, it's truly really happy. It makes you happy, it brings a smile to your face.
So tell me, why did you enjoy the Colour Run 2015?
It's something really creative and unique, and it's not something you see every day and you go to every day, so it's really fun.
Was it the happiest 5K on the planet?
Yes, it definitely was, because it's just so much excitement in it. So it's just so much fun.
So how was your experience?
A lot of emotion. A very good run. It's fun to have a color on your face.
Omar, one of the professional athletes that actually ran the 5K Colour Run in Dubai. Can you please tell us about this event?
This is the happiest 5K on the planet, and it was a celebration of life. I'm full of color, look at me. It was just about having fun, about people coming and getting active, which is what I'm all about, right? Active life is also all about that, right? About having a good time. And this was what it was all about today. People laughing, all shapes, all colors, tall, young. Everybody was here and throwing color and enjoying life. It was a celebration. It wasn't a workout. It wasn't timed. It wasn't, you know, 12,000 people. 12,000 people did it. And I gotta tell you, it really fired me up. It brings me back to basics. It reminds me of why I play sports, you know, because it's fun.
Well, for me and for all the participants here at the Color Run 2015, this was definitely the happiest 5K on the planet. Reporting from the Autodrome, this is Afra Al-Joun.
Lifeguards from all over the UAE gathered at the Le Meridien, Al Akhar and Fujairah for the annual UAE National Lifeguard Championships. This was a one-day event designed to challenge the skills and physical fitness of lifeguards through a series of competitive challenges. Steve was at the beach to give us the lowdown.
Six-pack abs, great physique, orange shorts, and David Hasselhoff. These are some of the things that come to mind when we hear the word lifeguard. And today, we're going to bring all of those to your tops because here at the UAE National Lifeguard Championships, we're going to test the lifeguard's leadership skills, emergency response, and of course, intense physical fitness.
Today, 10 years on, we're 26 teams. And we have the same level of an international competition. We have the same rules, same regulations, same events as the Australians or the American or British competition. So we're very proud of this event that's developed over the years. That's now got 26 teams, 140 competitors from all around the UAE. It's an event that's developed over the years, and hopefully in the next few years, we're going to see it going GCC-wide and eventually international. The different challenge, there's seven challenges in a day. They're all quite physical. Some of them are running, some of them are in the sea, and some of them are combining the two together. And some events are combining their lifeguarding skills. There's two main objectives to our competition. One is to test and applaud and make the lifeguards proud of what they do and show their skills. The second objective, equally important, is to make a big awareness to the population, to people who like to enjoy the sea and the swimming pools, to make them aware of the jobs of a lifeguard.
National Lifeguard Championships. I'm with
Amru,
Nader, Taiba.
And you are guys from?
University of Sharjah.
What do you think is the hardest challenge so far?
In my opinion, I think it was the 1 kilometer on the sand, because the sand was so thick. When you sand, your legs so go deep inside, and when you want to get up, you feel like you are getting like 10 kilograms on your legs, and it stick out your breath.
And how did you prepare for this?
Well, training. For the 1 kilometer, of course, we need to run about 3 to 4 kilometers running.
One of the proudest team here at the UAE National Lifeguard Championships, we have
Atlantis Adventure.
Okay, now I have their leader, Abdullahi. First of all, how did your team prepare for this one?
For sure, we have been prepared for 6 weeks. I mean, for this competition of UAE Championship.
And how confident are you that you guys are the best team here?
Yeah, we are so confident with ourselves. We trust our coach, we trust our team, we trust our company at all time. We did our best.
I'm here right now with Team Dubai Municipality, with Alex, Nina, Kizu, and Fatty. What do you think so far has been the hardest challenge so far?
For me, the hardest challenge for me is the run, swim, run. This is my first time enjoying here in UAE Lifeguard Championship, but it's really fun and experience.
And lastly, for Captain Alex, Captain, what is your message to all the lifeguards watching right now around the world?
Around the world, the message is very simple. Stay fit always and healthy, because this is the key to be able to perform your duty as a lifeguard to save people's lives. This is the best.
three-time beach flag champion Ari from Indonesia is right here with me. First of all, Ari, congratulations for winning the third time in a row. Yeah. How do you feel right now?
I feel it's awesome, you know.
What was the hardest part of the challenge?
Well, that's for that, like, push up, turn on your body must quick. Yeah. Just running also, very quick also. You must focus with the whistle.
Sprint relay winners, Wild Wadi women's team right now. How do you feel?
I feel amazing. I feel pumped, energized. This is such a great day. I love it.
How important is this kind of challenge in the daily life of a lifeguard?
It's definitely very important because, I mean, we're on position like quite far back and then there'll be someone drowning in the water and we have to run across the sand. So we need to be fit and, you know, ready to run across the sand. So it's very important, yeah.
Physique TV, do your best.
This was such a great and fun-filled event to show the public that these lifesavers are not only the beach to look good, but of course, their utmost priority is safety. Reporting from Fujairah, I'm Steve, and that's What's Up.
In celebration of the UAE Innovation Week, the Dubai Health Authority hosted a series of activities at the Health Innovation Village. The village was put up at Kite Beach and featured health awareness campaigns, brainstorming with healthcare innovators, and competitions for the public. Physique TV talked to Dr. Haider Youssef, Director of Health Funding from the Dubai Health Authority, to give us more details about the Health Innovation Village.
Week and Dubai government organizations are all participating in the Innovation Week. So Dubai Health Authority's initiative is the Innovation Village, basically, where it is really bringing a new perspective to look at health. Health, as we know, sometimes can be a fairly rigid subject. So we want people to interact with health and to basically communicate with the health system in a much more innovative way that yields a much better outcome for them and their families. So it's healthy behavior leading to rewards, leading to further healthy behavior. And that's one of the innovative projects of the Dubai Health Authority. This will be a regular event, and the DHA, through its new strategy, is looking to be innovative in everything that it does, and it how engages people with the health system of the Emirate of Dubai.
We're going to be doing a variety of different things. So we're focusing on some of the Emirati foods, sort of contemporary style, healthy salads. And what we're doing is we're basically doing a small variation. We're not using ghees, we're not using butters. We're avoiding anything like full cream milks, full fat milks. We're avoiding all of that. And so what we're trying to do is keep the flavor, keep the authenticity of the dish, but a little more contemporary. So that's kind of what we're doing this week. So, I mean, for people coming down, we'll be doing a couple of different dishes. Tonight we're doing chicken with a camel milk sauce, which is very good. We're doing tabbouleh, we're doing a couple of things, salads, desserts, all very healthy. So if people wanted to learn more, we'd be here for the next 7 days. Health is key. I mean, health is key. So, you know, the one thing that you've got basically from sort of like when you leave school and or whatever, you've got to get through till your older years or whatever. And it's absolutely critical that in eating well and looking after your diet and not eating all the wrong kinds of foods and the wrong kinds of quantities, you know, that you're probably going to do much better in terms of your health, your blood sugar, your cholesterol levels, your lifestyle. A lot of our lifestyle diseases are directly attributable to the food we eat.
The innovation that we have two initiatives. The first one is healthy Emirati cooking. We took ladies from Emirates and we give them machines to do a healthy cooking, and we teach them plus physical activities, exercise, because UAE and actually Arab Gulf having a lot of obesity, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases. And one of the preventions is to have such an initiatives.
Very important to build awareness towards a healthier community. I think you need to be innovative in attracting the community to these kind of activities. It's about engagement. You want to engage people, you want to get them to take more healthy decisions about their life, and that's what this event is all about.
Now don't go anywhere, because when we come back, let's travel to the Cave Rotana Razzle Khaymah for On The Go. Miss Universe Olivia Culpo shares her fitness and beauty secrets. Dubai yoga lovers celebrate sun, sand and savasana at Kite Beach. And check out the highlights from the first Korean food festival in Dubai. Welcome back to What's Up. This week, Amy and Firas are still in Ras Al Khaimah, but they've travelled to the picturesque The Cove Rotana Resort.
Welcome to On The Go. Join us as we travel by land, sea and air to show you the coolest hotspots around. We'll go on healthy food trips, exciting adventure outings and fun parties. Plus, we'll show you what's new and trending. So fasten your seatbelts, because you're in for a ride. This week, we're visiting the beautiful emirate of Ras Al Khaimah, where we're going to be staying at the Cove Rotana, which is a wonderful five-star resort situated on a hillside. It's only 45 minutes away from Dubai, so it's a quick drive, which makes it a perfect weekend retreat. I've never been to the Cove Rotana, but before coming, I did a little bit of research so I knew what to expect. The hotel is based on a hillside and looks like a little village, with each of the hotel rooms representing a small villa. It's absolutely stunning. As you drive in, you come through an archway and you're met by the beautiful sea view, and it's so pretty, you don't even feel like you're in the UAE. The weather in the UAE is getting slowly better, so there's less humidity in the air, and here in Ras Al Khaimah it is a lot less humid than in Dubai, so you can really enjoy the beautiful weather and take advantage of the beautiful pools here at the Cove Rotana and the beach. So we were staying in a beautiful villa, which was decorated in an old town style. And we had our own plunge pool, beautiful balconies that overlooked the sea. It was absolute perfection. But I wanted to take full advantage of the facilities here, so I quickly got ready and headed down to Bodylines Gym, where I was going to be having a kickboxing class. So I've been learning to kickbox for a couple of months now, so I kind of know the basics. So it was great to work out with Jason, who is a different coach, who taught me a few new moves.
So I'm here with Jason at Bodylines Gym, and we're going to do a mixed martial art class. So you're going to teach me a few moves?
Sure.
Let's give it a go. We got that hunger, hunger. We got that ground. We got that
shake, that jump to the drop, that jump in line. It's a great cardio workout, and I love kickboxing. It works out full body, it's great for the core, and really gets your heart rate going. So during the lesson, we worked on straight punches, some hooks, some jabs, and we also work on my kick. Jason was really pushing me on my flexibility and getting those kicks extra high. So after my kickboxing class, I hit the showers and went and took full advantage of the plunge pool that was in our villa. Freshened up a little bit and then I hit the poolside on the infinity pool to have a cooking lesson with the chef. So the view from the infinity pool is outstanding. You're quite high up on the resort, so you overlook the villas below as well as the lake and the beautiful sea view. Next to the infinity pool is the sunset bar where you can have a light bite to eat, and again you've got that stunning view of the whole resort. So while I was at the poolside, I had the honour of meeting Chef Shadi, who cooked with me two beautiful healthy dishes. So here I am at the beautiful sunset pool, which is the infinity pool here at the Cove Ratana. And joining me is Chef Shadi, and we've got some healthy dishes that we're going to share with you today. So Chef, tell me, what are we going to be cooking?
We will do very simple, healthy cocktail. It's made of banana and mango.
Lovely.
Okay, and pineapple juice with a pinch of lemon juice. This cocktail is good for spa. Yep. And it's good for gym as well.
Okay, so you can have it in the morning before your workout.
Exactly.
Give you that extra energy boost.
It gives you a lot of energy, okay. Plus, it gives you vitamin C and E as
yep.
well. It's vitamin B1, 3, and 6.
Perfect.
So put the banana inside.
This is fresh apple juice.
Fresh apple juice.
And a little bit of lemon juice. Okay, right. So just a squeeze of lemon. There we go. Wow, that is so tasty. You can taste all the different fruits blended together. It's got a nice little tang to it. At the same time, you've got all that sweetness from the mango. It's definitely going to be a great smoothie to have on a morning to give you that energy boost for the rest of the day. So Chef, I believe you have one more dish that you would like to share with me today. Can you tell me what it is?
It's also a very healthy dish. It's crab salad with tomato, chilled tomato soup.
Okay,
so prepare for the tomato soup. It's just a cold one.
Okay.
So as you see, tomato.
Yeah.
We add a little bit of coriander leaves.
Yeah.
Vinegars, olive oil, and salt, pepper, and sugar.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's
blend it.
So this is the crab meat, yeah?
It's a crab meat, it's pasteurized from the blue crabs.
Okay.
Okay, we add a little bit of chopped tomato.
Chopped tomato,
skinless.
Lovely.
Okay, a little bit of onions.
Lovely.
A bit garlic.
I love garlic.
Yeah, garlic is the best. And then a little bit of coriander, fresh coriander. Okay. This here, it's mix of olive oil and lemon juice.
And lemon, okay, so that's why it's separating like that.
Yeah, okay. As usual, if you like some salt, some crushed black pepper.
Yeah.
Okay, and we mix them all together. It's simple salad, okay, healthy, okay, for people who worry about them health.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, I think seafood and shellfish is always a good option if you're on a diet or if you're very health conscious.
Exactly.
It's very light, it's not a lot of fat.
Yeah, exactly. And this one, it's like 340 calories.
Okay.
So it's very good to have as a meal as well. Okay, so this is our salad.
Yeah.
And then we take our blended tomato soup. If you like more into lemon taste, you can add some lemon zest.
Lemon zest, okay, lovely.
With some herbs, whatever herbs you like.
Okay.
Okay, mix it a little bit. Okay, and we just dash it around. We serve it with some lavash bread. Okay, and we garnish it with some sakura leaves. Okay.
Lay the garnish on top.
And that's it, this our plate.
Absolutely beautiful. So this is a really nice light salad. You've got obviously the cooling tomato soup there around the side,
with the crab salad inside and only 340 calories?
340 calories.
You can't go wrong.
Yeah.
So after the cooking class, I decided to take a walk around the resort. It is so beautiful and it's perfect for some photo opportunities. So I had a little photo shoot and just took in the wonderful scenery. The resort is laid out like a small village, so you can take a buggy ride around to take in all the views. But in my opinion, it's much better to take a walk around. It's based on some hills, you've got some flat areas, so it's a great way to have a little extra cardio. Perfect day at the Mediterranean restaurant Basilico, where we opted, of course, for some healthy dishes. I had the beef carpaccio along with the Chilean sea bass, and Faraz had a lady's steak.
Wow, this looks amazing and smells great too.
This is a fish.
The great thing about a dish like this is that seafood is really healthy and it's low in fat, and it's a really light meal as well, so it's not going to leave you bloated. And this smells great, so I can only imagine how great it's going to taste.
So we're having a great, healthy dinner.
Healthy dinner.
Full of protein, me and you tonight. That's really nice.
And of course, your steak has lots of iron in it. Mm-hmm. And it's suitable for ladies.
Both dishes were absolutely beautiful. So tasty, and if I could go back and have it again, I most definitely would. So we started the day with some kickboxing, we had a healthy cooking class, we took a tour of the resort and finished with a beautiful meal at Basilico. We've done so much today, but I can't wait to see what we have in store tomorrow.
This is so relaxing.
With 2016 fast approaching, we've been asking you what your healthy New Year's resolutions are. Here's Fitness Q&A.
Well, my New Year's resolutions are to work out more, vary up my workouts, try something new, just to try to become a better person and a fitter person. And I'm a huge chocoholic, so I need to reduce that and start eating more fruits and vegetables like my mom's told me to. So yeah, that's my plan for the year ahead, and I'm very excited for what 2016 will bring.
I've got to go to the gym more, and I'm running the Dubai Marathon here, so got to get myself ready for that as well. Because I'm here, it's a good distance to run, nice little challenge, feels good.
My healthy New Year's resolution is to continue running, to run outside, to run more, to continue the 1.5 kilometers, to stop eating as much unhealthy food, just generally to be a little bit more fit than I have been. It's important to be healthy because I suppose you'll live a longer life, a more fulfilling life, you'll have a lot more energy, and just generally be a lot more positive.
My New Year's resolution is to drink less, exercise more, and eat better.
Well, I'm going to try and blend a lot more so I can get a good, healthy, balanced diet in first thing in the morning, and try and eat good, balanced proteins throughout the day. Avoid snacking on rubbish, sugary foods. I think that's my New Year's resolution. It's my job. I'm a physiotherapist. I have to advocate health, otherwise people get diabetes, blood pressure problems, cholesterol problems. Worst thing you could possibly have. Healthy lifestyle's the way forwards.
When we come back, meet Miss Universe Olivia Culpo on Celebrity Fit. Dubai yoga lovers celebrate sun, sand and savasana at Kite Beach. And check out the highlights from the first Korean food festival in Dubai. The Miss Universe 2015 pageant is set to take place in Las Vegas, USA on the 20th of December. So in line with this, our guest for this week's Celebrity Fit is the pageant's 2012 winner from Mexico, Olivia Culpo. In her recent visit to Dubai, Zahira was able to secure a one-on-one interview to get to know her more.
We've been fortunate enough to get a sit down with Miss Universe Olivia Culpo. Olivia, welcome to Physique TV.
Thank you.
Since winning the pageant in 2012, what project have you been up to? What exciting projects do you have on the go and coming up?
Oh my gosh, so many projects that I've been doing, that I have going on. The most exciting, I guess, that I can talk about right now, because I'm here in Dubai for it, is the Belle Femme makeup tutorial with my friend Patrick Ta. I've been doing all things fashion, beauty, acting, scripted, non-scripted, television, really just everything.
Now, staying as beautiful as you are can't be easy when you've got such a hectic schedule in terms of managing what's expected from you from all your sponsors and your partner brands and all the exciting things you have on the go. What's your basic beauty routine?
Okay, first of all, you're beautiful too, and you probably have a crazy schedule, so I just want to throw it back at you for a minute. And I guess my beauty routine is pretty standard. I just try to wash my face every day. I really try to not wear makeup on the days that I don't have to, because that would totally clog your pores. I try to keep a healthy diet going, not only so I look okay, but so I feel okay. Sleep is a huge one. Drinking lots of water is also a very big one for me.
Now, you're in Dubai, like you said, for Masterclass on Saturday. What can people expect from it?
A lot of fun, because Patrick is one of my best friends and we always have fun together. But obviously just beauty trends, tips, tricks, and that's probably pretty standard, yeah.
Now, you have a pretty hectic schedule, as you said, and keeping fit and healthy is something that either comes to some people or doesn't come to some people, and judging by you, you're just beautiful all year round. But how do you maintain that? How do you keep up? What is your schedule?
I like to just keep everything in moderation. So I do work out, but it's not too extreme. I do eat what I would love to eat naturally all the time. Really, I don't really stick to a diet. It's more just a lifestyle and a habit of not overeating, or, you know, not having French fries every single day, but maybe once a month. You know, I think it's important to indulge and enjoy life, but just also in moderation.
There's a lot of women in the world that aspire to be as you are, or as successful as you are, whether it's from a beauty pageant perspective, business perspective, fashion perspective. What advice do you have for them?
There's a lot of things that I'm still learning, so I'm flattered that you say that, but I think that something I've learned is not being afraid to take advice from other people and look at what other people have done that you aspire to do as well. And also, just, I've been fortunate enough to have people in my life that have guided me in certain ways and given me advice that really did help, and I wouldn't be where I am today if it wasn't for those people. So just not being afraid to take others' advice, not being too hard on yourself when people criticize you, and really just thinking of things as an observer of your own life instead of thinking so personally, you know, just really take into consideration what people throw at you and the advice they have and criticism, basically. That's what I'm saying.
I love that you mentioned balance, because for me that's something that's very real, because I think when you sit and speak to someone who's very rigid about a program, it's not really very tangible to most people. When you talk about balance and fitness, when you do get in the gym or you do something fitness related, what is it?
I love Pilates. I love Bar Method, so I don't know, do you guys have Bar Method here? So that's another thing, it's just really more for me about strengthening and toning and lengthening too. So I love to stretch, I love yoga, but I'm not going to be the type of person that will go mountain climbing or do CrossFit or run 5,000 miles. It's just too much.
That gives me hope, because I hate running too. Thank you so much for chatting to us today.
Thank you. Hey guys, this is Olivia Culpo and this is Physique TV. Be your best.
Lovers of yoga came together at the Kite Beach for the Sun, Sand and Savasana event organised by Lululemon Athletica. Afra was there to check it out.
I
I'm here today at Kite Beach with all the yoga lovers that came here today to enjoy the sun and sand as one community. Let's find out more about this gathering. Miss Vanessa, one of the organizers of this beautiful event. So Vanessa, can you tell us what is the objective of today's event?
So whenever we enter a new market, we always love to bring our aspect of community, and the company is really rooted in yoga. So we love to bring yoga to the community. We felt like it was very appropriate for Dubai to do it near the beach. The weather's beautiful, the sun is shining. And the theme of the actual class is Fuel Happiness, which is our global campaign around just really generating really simple 5-minute practices to fuel self-happiness. So we hosted a 60-minute yoga practice. It was led by two of our yoga ambassadors, Omar and Melissa, who teach at Urban Yoga and Zen Yoga respectively. The intention they set for the class was around fueling inner happiness. And following the class, we've got people able to go and check out our 7 happiness stations and participate in an interactive activity that actually allows them to be in the practice of that certain type of happiness. We'll continue to be bringing yoga to the community so they can count on more.
With me here, Louise, one of the participants of this beautiful event. Hello, how are you?
Hi, I'm good, thank you. I'm good, thank you.
I hope you're having a great morning here with the yoga community. It's very beautiful.
Yeah, it's gorgeous. It's such a nice atmosphere and the weather's great.
So why do you like practicing yoga?
Honestly, I probably only do it once in a blue moon, mainly when I'm persuaded by friends. I think I like the fact that it's stretching, like you always feel really stretched out afterwards, but you also get a lot more of a workout than I think people think.
Here, do you think you're going to do it again?
Yeah, no, I'll definitely try it out again, and this was really good fun. Like I like the atmosphere when it's a good workout, but people aren't taking it too seriously. You know, it's nice for beginners and that.
I'm here with Danae, who is also a participant of this beautiful event. Hello.
Hi.
So did you enjoy this event?
Yeah, it was really lovely and such a nice crowd, nice environment. Yeah.
What is your main goal about doing yoga?
Well, I quite like that it relaxes me and calms me down. That's pretty much it. It just sort of soothes me. And being out here in this sort of beautiful atmosphere is perfect.
Good morning, Mindy.
Good morning.
So can you share this beautiful beach experience with us?
I'd love to. I had a great time. I feel strong. I feel at peace.
With me here is Ashton to talk about his yoga experience with us.
It was great. This was actually my first time doing a yoga ever. And it was really good. It was really relaxing, especially with the beach and the weather and the breeze. Everything was just perfect.
So do you think you're going to do it again?
I think so. I actually do think so. I will do it again.
It was another beautiful, relaxing yoga morning here at the beach. I'm Efra, and that's What's Up.
Dubai had a taste of South Korea in the first ever Korean food festival held at the Zabil Park. The inaugural food fair featured a lineup of South Korean games, entertainment, cuisine and activities for friends and families. After a successful run in Malaysia and Indonesia, the South Korean Ministry of Agriculture, Food and Rural Affairs organised this event for UAE residents and tourists to be able to enjoy the diversity of Korean dishes.
Table fair is to introduce Korean food in Dubai because people here haven't had many chances to experience Korean food. There are a lot of companies dealing with fresh products and also beverages. Basically all the foods we are showcasing here are very healthy, but especially fresh products we apply very strict quality standard and hygiene standard. So you guys rest assured that Korean food is very healthy and pretty much good for your body. Many people are from Korea here, and this is very much cosmopolitan city. So I can see a lot of people from different cultural background, and I hope all of them can enjoy Korean food too. Because I heard that more than 90% of population here from different countries. So basically this is another type of like melting pot. A lot of multicultural city, very diverse and dynamic. So all the people here can enjoy Korean food and Korean culture, that'll be very good.
We have the Korean pears from the Jinju area, which is grown in the cold weather, so it's like the more sweet. It has a like very firm texture because we give like extra attention to like how it grows. So it makes like that's the voice our secret to grow the nice fruits. This is the like fresh cut pears. This is perfect for the fresh cut dessert because it's also more like really juicy. At the same time, it's hydrating. It's perfect for the summer weather. Have the like air-dried pear, which is like you can easily carry it, and this is like perfect for the full of vitamins and the fibers.
We are from Nonghyeop, the National Agriculture Cooperative Federation from Korea, so we're trying to promote our fruit in the UAE, especially our pear, apple and persimmon. I can say that it contains more vitamins and it's very sweet. It's more fruity and juicy. So yeah, we just like to promote our night fruit in the UAE country.
I'm introducing my product like dried, half dried persimmon and dried persimmon slice. It's good for health. All the, my product is natural. Benefit is persimmon has a lot of vitamin C. Yeah, it's good for human fatigue.
Ginseng from Korea is different from other countries' ginseng. Ginseng contains saponin, it's much higher than other countries. Saponin helps your body below, it shows effect of red ginseng. It helps your blood sugar adjustment and blood pressure, liver, all things in your body, it helps. So Korea ginseng much higher contains saponin. That's why most people like Korea ginseng.
Again, the headlines today. The Color Run 2015 continues to spread happy and healthy vibes. UAE holds National Lifeguard Championships 2015. Dubai Health Authority celebrates UAE Innovation Week. And on Celebrity Fit, Miss Universe Olivia Culpo shares her fitness and beauty secrets. Thanks once again for joining me today. If you have any comments or suggestions, connect with us on our social media pages. I'm Rachel. See you next time.